I come from the machinery side, so I don't have those interesting marketing ideas. But I was just thinking that the design of packages finally depend on the materials. You need materials to design something, to produce something. And I come from the side of machinery that is renowned for materials. So I would like to, well, cut down these slides, because I think these things have been discussed so much since morning that I have little to contribute, and the people who spoke about them are much bigger authorities on these ideas. But let's say that in general, what consumers want is the same thing as the marketers want, because marketers can't want anything else, otherwise they will fail. And that's what the manufacturers want. For my role comes in as to how the material side, which means machinery and technologies, help the package designers to choose the materials, and how we contribute in printing, graphics, and so on. So let's say that these are the basic advantages of flexible packaging. The biggest advantage from the viewpoint of this conference is that it leads to easy innovation in package designs. You can have all kinds of shapes, you can have all kinds of graphics, you can have all kinds and sizes, portions and things like that. It's very easy for a designer. There are other advantages such as economies, low carbon footprint and so on, but I think also recyclability and let's say sustainability, sustainable production, all these ideas could be discussed at length, but we don't have the time for it. So let's say easy designing of variety of portions, easy, this we have done. What is flexible packaging doing in our lives? Actually, it is touching our lives almost every second. You see, snack foods, personal hygiene and home products, medical and pharma products. Retail, multiple use carry bags, food products, meat, confectionery, and industrial products. I would like to very briefly touch upon how the design of films is done in order to achieve certain objectives of the products which have to be packaged, for which the able designers sitting here design their packages. I will not go into this because challenge of price, cost, everything is well known. The challenge is essentially technological upgradation and innovation. And what has happening in the industry is new polymers. Therefore, we have to design new films to facilitate the design of packaging, high quality, high speed printing. Flexographic printing is also making a huge contribution, because I just heard that Venky was right, saying that whatever time has been lost in designing and all the other processes, finally the converter has to fill this time quickly. And flexo printing can actually bring the design from artwork to press in a matter of hours. So this is a huge advantage there. So what should we do? I mean, how do you design? I think there are two important ingredients. One is system approach to R&D, in which the machine builders, the raw material suppliers, additives, and master batch suppliers, ink and adhesive suppliers, processors, converters, end users, and logistics must work together. I will just bring an example to you. And an integrated approach in designing and manufacturing, which means knowledge of processes from start to finish, such as extrusion, printing, converting, integrating technologies for reduced operator dependence, because that's where the errors arise. Technologies to reduce carbon footprint and increased safety. Futuristic orientation, this is very important. And flexibility to enable packages. For example, barrier packaging required for ovens, for microwave, or for retort and things like that. So the films are designed accordingly for that. Consumer applications like labels. Here, I think the biggest manufacturer of labels is here. Our good friend Viraj Bhai is here from Chris. Excellent. The plastic labels replace paper labels mainly because of the advantages which are shown here, mainly excellent properties, both optical and printing. More flexible in packaging design because you need a lot of shrink labels and variety of labels which you can't do with paper. And they're resistant against humidity. Other consumer applications which you see now more and more coming to the market are collation, which is, and usually now collation is full printed, as you can see here. more and more this is the kind of stuff which is coming into India. Pouches, you see every day, all kinds of snack foods are served in pouches and in all kinds of portions. These films are designed by usually individual films or through a combination of films which are called laminations, usually which are polyester films with polyethylene films. Then you need reclosable packaging. The popular solutions are zippers, sticky tape, easy peels, and hot melt for reclosability and booklet kind of packaging. These are things which you see already quite a lot worldwide and is more and more coming into India. I would skip that.
3 minutes more.
So you see these are some specialized films for toothpaste tubes where aluminium foil is being replaced. You can understand the reasons very easily because the marketers want that the people can see the toothpaste. And aluminium makes it difficult to recycle the product. Coffee films are required to be highly high aroma barrier films because coffee is a very sensitive product and loses aroma very quickly. And it's like toothpaste, I think, more or less very, very rigid specifications are there. This is a typical example of a tray film along with a lid. This is a PA, which is nylon and EVOH system, which is a very high barrier system and is ideal for packaging of meat, sausages, and variety of products, seafoods, and so on. This is a new. This is a case which I want to tell you about. That this is a new introduction from our company. This is not a company presentation, but Aquarex is a new kind of downward extrusion blown film line, which produces the cooling system is actually water. The technology in principle is not new. This idea is very old, but what has been done technologically here is something very different. And what happens as a result is we get film with high transparency and gloss, high seal strength, high tensile strength, or tearing strength, soft touch, because I've been hearing about the touch since morning. Yes, and you get a wonderful touch, no leakers, high output, barrier and non-barrier films can be produced, and very high speed running on FFS machines because of excellent sealability. So this study was conducted in India with the largest single producer of edible oils in the country, and this was truly an integrated approach. This is the case I wanted to talk to you about. The test was carried out in a joint project by the machine builders, which are us, the film manufacturers, the end users, and transportation across India. The material package was edible oil, which you see every day. Supplier was one of the largest brands in India. Result, no leakers, nil damaged pouches, travel through the toughest terrains and longest distances in the country. India is notorious for roads. India is notorious for logistics because of that, and transportation is a major issue, and all packaging people have to concentrate on that. High performance, FFS machines run at full speed, 40 pouches per minute, and the film had the potential to run faster, but could not be done because that was the machine limitation. There's a typical oil pouch, I will not go into that. So well, what do we do? What is the outlook? How many things we must replace? Replacement of three-layer oil or ghee pouch. Is that going to be with a white elephant if we need so many replacements or so many different applications from the machine? Substitution of laminates, substitution of transparent toothpaste films to make toothpaste films which are transparent. Rice packaging, you might have already seen these packages where you have windows through which you can see the rice. Sugar, transparent to be able to see the sugar and grain size. For atta, pastry or whatever. Film for dry fruits and legumes because people want to see them. Film for spice packaging, substitution for PVC. These are PVC packages in which undergarments are packed for Hanes in America. Well, so all these performance parameters must be met. Do we need a white elephant? No, just a cash cow, just one single system. So this is a case study which demonstrates that technology can help the package designers in a huge, huge way. I will skip the remaining slides and I will go directly now to show you just a little bit of flexo printing. I'll take maybe 1 minute.
Yeah, that's okay.
One minute or 1.5 minutes, something like that. So we have to integrate everything. I said to you that within hours you can have an artwork on the press, and then when it comes to the press, there are new problems on the press because you need to do color matching, you need to do impression setting, you need to do register setting, and so on. So we are able to integrate today with very high technologies all these systems in let's say on the machine, which can be done now. These functions can be performed within minutes actually. So there's a static system where material change, leaf change, ink change, and deck pre-setting can be done. This is also static. And then there is proofing, which is dynamic. During this time, we do quality check, color matching, and deck fine setting. And then we are in production. And I would like to show you, these are called our, let's say, easy family systems. Easy call, the color matching takes the most time and creates most waste. So there is another technology which is also part of Easy Family, which helps you to significantly reduce ink wastage and improve the, let's say, delivery time. This one single system, as you can see, is the entire environment for the system. You have the X-Rite system, which is reading on the right side, the artwork on the or the original print, and then it is processed, and then it goes into color matching so that inks can be decided, and the inks can be fed to the machine immediately. And after that, the print is on, and I said to you about Easy Set and Easy Registration, and within minutes, you are in register, you are in right color, and you are within, let's say, 2 or 3 or 4 delta. I would skip that. The great feature in this is that today you don't have to have a number of cameras, and you don't have to scan small portions of a print. But with a line camera here, you can, in this high definition system, you can scan the whole print at a time, and therefore you can bring the machine into registration in one go. Another great technology that has gone into the machines now is Easy View, which is a live print image. This is actually a plate. This is a plate. This is a demonstration plate. And this goes into the machine. And inside the machine reads this completely. Those adapters, sleeve, tape, plate, design, speed-related tolerances. Because if you set a plate outside and if you bring it to the machine, there will be tolerances on all systems, and therefore they will all come together and you will lose the print. And therefore, this is done in true dynamic measurement under real production conditions inside the machine. And by doing this, we are into the perfect setting within seconds, actually in seconds. What does it do? It detects the high and low spot areas and then adjusts the impression and ensures very low waste reduction. So these are technologies which are helping the designers to design more and more difficult graphics, which can be translated into prints in a matter of hours. There are films which can perform for various requirements, for various shelf life requirements, for various proportioning, and so on. So this is the machine perspective to help the designers to design the packages as they want. Thank you very much.